Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. Let's start the current affairs for 20th of August. Now here it's written welcome to Dampa Tiger Reserve. So Dampa Tiger Reserve is in which state? Write down in comments. Who has been named as the best sportsperson of India by Calcutta Sports Journalist Club? He is the captain of the Indian football team. He also plays for Bengaluru Football Club. His name is Sunil Chhatri. Sunil Chhatri. Now there were some other awards also that were handed over. Best Junior Sportsperson of the Year is Ishan Porel. He is a cricketer. Lifetime Achievement Awards were given to three people: Arun Ghosh, Arun Lal and Akhtar Ali. Best Athlete Men is Safiqul Mondol. And Best Athlete Woman is Bhairavi Roy. Also remember, there were special awards that were given to Hima Das and Deepa Karmakar. Hima Das recently won the 400 meter race. She became the world champion. And Deepa Karmakar, she won the Gymnastics World Challenge recently. Now Hima Das is from Nagaon in Assam and Deepa Karmakar is from Tripura. Deepa Karmakar's coach is Bisheshwar Nandi and she does a very peculiar jump which is called Produnova. Which of the following cities will host the Shooting World Cup in 2020? The International Shooting Sports Federation is called ISSF and it is headquartered in Munich. Munich is in Germany. Capital of Germany is Berlin. So we are talking about Delhi. Delhi will host the 2020 ISSF World Cup. And this will take place just before the Tokyo Olympics. And the Tokyo Olympics mascot is Mirai Tova. And for the Paralympics, it is Someti. Which of the following organizations has launched a new campaign, which is called Our Safety, Our Rights? This organization is Amnesty International. It works for the preservation of the human rights so that they are not violated. And the aim of this campaign is to create awareness amongst children to help them understand and identify sexual abuse, to teach them what is good touch, what is bad touch, to empower them to understand if they are being sexually abused. And they will take this campaign up in four states presently: Madhya Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. Which of the following countries has banned the import of pet coke for use as a fuel? Pet coke, it causes a lot of greenhouse effect. It emits greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide, etc. And greenhouse gases, they always increase the temperature of the atmosphere. And pet coke has more greenhouse effect. It has more greenhouse gas emission than even coal. So the country is India. India has banned the import of pet coke. India used to buy most of the pet coke from America. And in the Western countries, in fact, pet coke is just a waste product that India was buying. India earlier had also banned the import of oxytocin hormone that was being misused by the farmers to increase the vegetable size and also by the dairy farmers to have more milk production. Who has been awarded with the prestigious WHO World No Tobacco Day 2018 award for his extraordinary contribution towards tobacco control? He is right now the additional health director in Delhi. His name is S.K. Arora. In Delhi, the tobacco consumption has reduced by 27% against the national average of 17%. So in Delhi, tobacco consumption has reduced by 1/4. And remember, World No Tobacco Day, it is observed on 31st of May. And this time the theme was tobacco and heart diseases. Right. So that's all you need to remember. And WHO, well, it is headquartered in Geneva. And Tedros Adhanom from Ethiopia, he is the Director General. And Soumya Swaminathan from India, she is the Deputy Director General. Also remember, as per the National Health Policy of India, right, they have set a target of the relative reduction in tobacco prevalence by 15% by year 2020 and 30% by year 2025. The Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority has asked the insurance companies to cover which disease under medical insurance policy. So they have asked the insurance companies to cover mental illnesses also now under the claim. What benefit it will have? One, of course, is the financial benefit because it will be covered now in your insurance policy. But the more important one is the social taboo that is associated with the mental diseases. It will be reduced. An IPS officer, his name is Mayank Jain. He has been forced to retire prematurely by the central government on a recommendation from which state's government? Because he is a very corrupt IAS officer, and 100 crore cash was seized from his house. So now he has been forced to retire prematurely. This decision has been taken by the government of Madhya Pradesh. Which company's India head, Mr. Amit Agarwal, has asked the employees to not take calls or answer emails after working hours between 6 p.m. and 8 a.m. Now, this company is known to have a very rigorous working schedule. So it's not just a 9-to-5 job. A lot of times it has been seen that the employees, they were working even after 5 o'clock. And this caused insomnia and mental stress. So now their India head Amit Agarwal has asked the employees not to take calls after routine working hours. It is Amazon. Amazon's founder is Jeff Bezos, the richest person in the world. His wealth is around $150 billion. And he owns a space agency also called Blue Origin. The American Treasury Department, they have imposed sanctions. These are military sanctions on 4 commanders and 2 entire military units of which country for their involvement in ethnic cleansing against the Rohingya Muslims. Rohingya Muslims were butchered in Rakhine state. You know, there was a genocide, and the word genocide was used by United Nations. They claimed they were very sure it's a genocide against the Rohingyas. That is, it is a state-sponsored genocide. And even the army of this country was complicit in the crime. This is Myanmar. Myanmar's old name was Burma. Let me show you Myanmar. So this is India's neighbor Myanmar. Its old name is Burma, as you can see in the bracket here. Capital is this, Naypyi Taw. And India is building something known as a Kaladan project. It's a multimodal project. Multimodal means there will be various types of ways. So from Kolkata port, you will have a sea route to Sitwe port. Now remember, Sitwe port is in Myanmar, very, very important. And then from Sitwe port, you will have a river route, and then you will have a road route. So this is the Kaladan multimodal project. And there are two important rivers in Myanmar that are asked in exam. One is this main river, which is called Irrawaddy River. Irrawaddy River. And after Irrawaddy River, we have named Irrawaddy dolphins also. Now in India, Irrawaddy dolphins are found maximum in the Chilka Lake. Chilka Lake, which is in Odisha, it is the largest lagoon lake in India. And this river is also very important. It is called Salween. S-A-L-W-E-N. Salween River and Irrawaddy Rivers are the main river. And Myanmar's president is Win Mint. Win, M-Y-N-I-T, W-I-N, Win Mint. And Aung San Suu Kyi is the foreign minister. World Humanitarian Day is observed on which date? World Humanitarian Day is observed on 19th of August. And there is a huge significance behind this. On 19th of August 2003, there was a terrorist attack in the capital of Iraq, which is Baghdad. This attack was on the United Nations headquarters of Iraq. It killed 22 people, and among those who lost their lives was Sergio Vieira de Mello. Don't forget his name, Sergio Vieira de Mello. He was the United Nations top representative in Iraq. So after 5 years, around 2007, the General Assembly adopted a resolution designating 19th of August as the World Humanitarian Day. According to Securities and Exchange Board of India data, SEBI is the capital market regulator. Investments through which derivative into Indian capital markets declined to over 9-year low till July end. This is because of the strict steps taken by the SEBI. This is regarding participatory notes. What are the strict steps? So there will be a $1,000 that is the money that you have to pay for every instrument. So that's an additional load on the person who is investing. Second, the NRI is the person of foreign origin. You know, the foreigners, the people of Indian origin, OCIs and PLOs, people who are living abroad, they are banned from investing in the participatory notes. So all this has led to, lowest investment through participatory notes in the last 9 years. SEBI's chairman is Mr. Ajay Tyagi. India's first mission to study the solar corona, the outer atmosphere corona, is planned to be launched in 2019-20 by the polar satellite launch vehicle called PSLV XL from Sriharikota in Andhra Pradesh. What is the name of this mission? The name of this mission is Aditya L1. And NASA is also launching a mission to study sun, which is called Parker mission. Solar Parker probe, named after Dr. Eugene Parker. Dr. Eugene Parker. Now write down in comments, who was Dr. Eugene Parker? What was his contribution? Former member of Lok Sabha, Chennupati Vidya passed away She was a 2-time Lok Sabha Member of Parliament from Vijayawada in Andhra Pradesh. She was a politician from which party? She represented Indian National Congress. World's oldest cheese has been discovered in which country? It has been discovered from Egypt. Egypt's capital is Cairo. There is an important place in Egypt called Tahrir Square, which was the hub of the Arab Spring. And in Egypt, you will find Nile River also. And you will also find in Egypt the pyramids, which are the wonders of the world. Right. And there is a player also from Egypt called Mohamed Salah, who plays for Liverpool Football Club. He was awarded the Professional Footballers Association PFA Footballer of the Year in England. World Photography Day was celebrated on which day? World Photography Day is observed on August the 19th. The Ministry of Water Resources, not Water Resources, Human Resources Development, HRD, the HRD Ministry has proposed to set up a 5-member committee to suggest changes to JEE Advanced. The committee will be headed by which person? Also remember the JEE exam, the NEET NEET exam, they will be conducted 2 times a year now, as was announced by the Ministry of HRD. This committee will be headed by Bhaskar Ramamurthy, and he is the director of IIT Madras. According to NABARD, National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development, they conducted a survey called All India Rural Financial Inclusion Survey 2016-17. The results are out. What is the percentage of rural income from farming? Now, some people believe that most of the rural income comes from farming. It is not the case. Less than 1/4. Only 23% of the rural income comes from agriculture in India. NABARD was established on 12th of July 1982 and Mr. Harsh Kumar Bhanwala, he is the chairman of NABARD. As per the NABARD survey, what is the average monthly net income of the agriculture households in India for the financial year 2016? The average monthly net income was 8,931 rupees. Who have bagged the bronze medal for India in the 10 meter air rifle mixed team event in Asian Games? Asian Games have started. They will take place in Jakarta and Palembang, 2 places this time. And a mixed pair means mixed team means one male, one female. So Apurvi Chandela and Ravi Kumar, they have won the bronze medal in shooting. Apurvi Chandela is from Jaipur, Rajasthan, and Ravi Kumar is from Uttar Pradesh. Who has won the gold medal for India in the 65 kilogram category by defeating Japanese Daichi Takatani in 18th Asian Games? By the way, he is the gold medalist in the 17th Asian Games also, which took place in South Korea in Incheon. He is Bajrang Punia. He is from Haryana. And this is the first gold medal of India in these Asian Games. Non-cooperation movement started in which year? Non-cooperation movement started on 1st of August 1920 because they were protesting against the Rowlatt Act. Now remember, on 1st of August 1920, just before the movement started, we had the unfortunate demise of Bal Gangadhar Tilak. So Bal Gangadhar Tilak also died on 1st of August 1920. Siachen Glacier conflict is between which countries? Siachen Glacier conflict is between India and Pakistan. Now let me show you why Siachen is so important. Now look at this map. The area in the green is actually the Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. And the area in yellow, this one, is actually China-occupied Kashmir, right? The Aksai chain, which China had occupied. So a lot of area of, you can see, Kashmir is occupied. Now Siachen is right in the middle, right? So if we let go of Siachen, then the Chinese occupied Kashmir and Pakistan occupied Kashmir, there will be a continuity. And this will be very dangerous for India, because then the Pakistan and China, they can have a synergy between their two forces. That is why Siachen is important. Even though not a single bullet has been fired in Siachen in the last 50 years, but and most of our jawans, they have been killed because of avalanche or because of snow or weather, harsh climatic conditions. Still, we need Siachen. That is why it is very important. So, and we have Siachen Glacier, Bal Toro Glacier, these are Bandura Glacier, these are some of the important glaciers in India. Who started the newspaper called Indian Opinion? Not just Indian Opinion, he also started another newspaper called Young India. Both of these were started by Mahatma Gandhi. And he also started one more newspaper called Harijan. Harijan was a weekly newspaper started by Mahatma Gandhi. Can you tell me any newspaper started by Bal Gangadhar Tilak? Write down in comments. So this was the video. And remember, our sale is on for Eid. It is just for 2 days till 22nd of August. I wish you a happy Eid in advance. And do share the video with your friends also. Thank you so much.